authority in Wales, they don't like it. The words of Neil McEvoy, a controversial politician who is currently not being called to speak in the Senedd. Earlier this week, I spoke to him about that and about trying to register his new party, but I began by asking him why he opposed the firebreak lockdown.
I think we need policies based on common sense and based on science. There's no science in closing businesses where you can actually conduct business safely. The virus needs to be taken seriously, but we need to enable people to go about their daily lives as safely as possible. And what I found really frustrating is we supported the first lockdown, but we didn't really have a proper lockdown. The airport was open, 24,000 people came in without being tested, the ports had been open, there were no restrictions on the roads, people coming in from highly infected areas. So I think what we need to do is look at this holistically.
You say there's no scientific advice, but it's the scientific advisers for the Welsh Government who said a short lockdown is exactly what's needed, and they followed that advice.
The 10 p.m. closure of pubs, for example, does not make sense, because people then all leave at the same time. So that's a very ill-advised policy. The businesses operate in the open air, which are going to the wall. I mean, people who've worked their whole lives to build up their businesses, they've seen them disappear. If you look at the schools as well, where we're at now, my own daughter goes to school, but there's a bubble. Where they can go is restricted. They go on the bus, and it's a free-for-all. And I think what people object to are the contradictions.
You've been voting against lockdowns and the current set of restrictions, but you're not able to contribute, speak in the Senedd at the moment, following a protest over a debate on racism. Now, the throw-in of the presiding officer of the Senedd says she won't call you unless you retract your accusations and apologise.
I've been in a situation for 4.5 years where I have been treated differently from any other member of the Senedd. That's a matter of record. I've not been called to speak when other people have. I've not been able to put questions when other people have been allowed to put questions. Roughly 13% of all emergency questions in the last 3 years have been put in by me, and not a single one has made the agenda. I've had the presiding officer attack me in public on social media, and I've even been told that people find me uncomfortable to deal with because of the way I look. I cannot apologise for something that I firmly believe. There was a debate on racism. I put forward 4 very sensible proposals, not only from me, they came from the community. The officials accepted my amendments. And then an hour before the meeting started, the presiding officer, the Plaid Cymru presiding officer, withdrew all my amendments in order to conduct proper business. So what the Senedd was saying up there was that proposals to combat racism at the sharp end, it's people like me who are abused in the streets. It's people like me who are discriminated against. It's people like me because of the way I look for some people who have different lives we do. And what I was saying is the only member of colour able to put forward proposals. I was saying, look, these things need looking at. And it was completely disrespectful.
You say you're treated differently and have been treated differently since you've been in the same room. But is that because you behave differently? You've got a long charge sheet, you know, it's only recently that your suspension for 4 months in Cardiff Council is finished, for example, for being accused of bullying a care home worker. You've been suspended for Plaid Cymru's group, kicked out of the party, suspended for another month as a Cardiff councillor. I could go on. Have you ever considered, even some of the time, that perhaps you're the problem?
I'm the problem for the Welsh establishment, clearly. And with the charge sheet, if you just go into a little bit more detail, then you'll reveal the full story. I was suspended for a month for supporting a family being unfairly evicted. I was suspended for 4 months speaking up for a child in care who is alleging abuse.
But they're not saying that it's wrong for you to do those things. They're saying it's the way you behave when doing those things that's a problem.
Well, what I find interesting is that with the 4 month suspension, it's got to the point now, James, where when I make a contentious phone call, I video myself doing so. Because when you challenge authority in Wales, they don't like it.
Let's talk about your new party then. You initially registered as the Welsh National Party. Plaid Cymru didn't like that. You've now rebranded again. What's the latest?
We rebranded as the Welsh Nation Party. The first reason was we were registered as the Welsh National Party, like and rejected. What we also picked up from the communities was that the word nation was seen and felt to be a lot more inclusive. And there were members saying to us, well, we've got a problem with the Welsh National Party, national, because of Wycombe's objection. Why don't we become the Welsh Nation Party? Because the idea of a nation is that you come to Wales and be part of the Welsh Nation. So it's very inclusive. So what we did, we reapplied. And by this point, we're our preferred name of Welsh Nation Party. And that's where we're at.
So if you register in time and get all the paperwork done, what platform do you have? At the end of the day, why would someone vote for your party instead of Ireland? Instead for of Glad Glad, instead of another party that supports independence?
It's a Labour and it's a Conservatives. Because we live in a country which has been dominated by a one-person party for 21 years. I don't think it's any secret that we have a lot of corruption in many ways in politics in Wales. And what we want to do is take on that corruption, clean up Cardiff Bay, give people a voice, and we want to make the Welsh Parliament work. There's a huge housing crisis in Wales. Youngsters can't get on the ladder. We're going to put forward sensible policies to change people's lives using the Welsh Parliament. And we're very serious about that. And our message is resonating. It is attractive. People do want change. We've had enough of Labour and the cartel. Why can they, and the Liberal Democrats, all they've done for 21 years is support Labour. So if you vote for those parties, you're going to get Labour. What we want to be is, for the first time ever, a credible opposition holding the government to account.
A Senedd spokeswoman told us Mr McAvoy has not apologised to the Senedd for disorderly behaviour. Once he does, he can again be called to speak, as others have done in the past. And that's it. I'll be back next Sunday at 10. Until then, have a great week. And we'll be back.